Hey everyone, it's Kevin. Welcome back to the channel. So with the holidays just around the corner, you might be needing some last minute gifts. And if you have a 3D printer, that just so happens to be a really great tool for making things. In this video, I'm going to show you five easy 3D printed gifts you can design in Blender yourself, even with really basic skills. Now you can absolutely download models from amazing resources like MakerWorld. There are a ton of community uploads from practical stuff like phone stands and cable clips to more decorative things like plant pots and light fixtures. Really, you can find just about anything. If you're looking to print something quickly, that is a great place to start. But if you do want to go one step further and create something custom that's a bit more meaningful, this video will hopefully give you some inspiration for things that you can design. Towards the end, I'll also call out a few other resources on MakerWorld you can use if you're pressed for time. All right, let's get into it. The first gift is a simple text keychain. This is one of the easiest things that you can design in Blender. And the biggest bonus is that it's fully customizable. If you want a full step-by-step walkthrough, I have a Blender beginner's guide where I go through this process in detail. In that video, I made a keychain for my dog Missile, and it's a really approachable way to start designing for 3D printing in Blender. If you're still getting used to the program, it's a good place to start because I go over the basics, working with text, thickness, and scale, and those ideas carry over into more complex designs that you'll eventually create later. I also got a lot of follow-up questions on that video about customization and print issues, especially around Booleans, so I just released a video covering a lot of those common problems and fixes, and I'll link that one below. This keychain idea doesn't only apply to text. If you have vector paths like a logo or a simple graphic, you can import those into Blender, give them geometry, and turn them into a keychain the same way. If you want it to be functional, you'll just need to add a hole or use some kind of chain or hardware. The second idea is a textured object like an ornament. I've been seeing a lot of really cool designs lately that look like fabric or knit materials, but they're actually 3D printed. What's cool is that these are totally achievable in Blender using displacement. I have another video where I walk through this process step by step, and the same technique can be applied to a variety of shapes and models. In that video, I used it to create some plant pots and fun pumpkins. Here, I use that same approach to create these knitted style ornaments, and you can download these for free off my Gumroad. The third item are plant pots. These are probably one of the easiest objects to design, and they're also incredibly flexible. You can check out my plant pot video where I walk through four different pots you can create. And once you understand the basics, which is really just creating a vessel with a cavity, you can customize it however you want. And it doesn't even have to stay just a plant pot. That same design can become a key console holder, a small organizer, or even a light fixture if you're using something like tea lights. It's a simple foundation that you can build a lot of different ideas upon. One common question that I got there was about planting directly into the pots. So most of the designs in that video are meant to be decorative. So you have a cash pot and then you have this cover pot. But if you do want to plant directly and you are using PLA, I'd recommend sealing it with a food safe sealer. PLA can break down over time if it's overexposed to moisture, so it's good to keep that in mind if you don't want the pot degrading or leaching into the soil. If you want to avoid sealing altogether, PETG is a better option to print with. The next idea are hue forge prints. So I've covered this in another video, but this is a really great option if you want to turn your 2D illustrations, photos, or designs into something physical that you can actually hold. I've used this process a lot in my 3D printing journey to create the first products on my shop, which were the collectible Kira cards and a bookmark. And it's honestly one of my favorite ways to translate 2D art into something physical. If you don't want to use hue forge, MakerLab also recently released a similar feature called Chroma Canvas. It works well for a lot of use cases, and I honestly haven't experimented with it extensively yet, but from what I've seen, it covers the basic functionality. That said, if you really want full control over color, depth, and to really dial those settings in, I'd still recommend Hue Forge. The last category is something functional or interactive. So prints that use additional components like NFC stickers, magnets, phone docks, lights, or even simple coasters with cork feed. For some ideas, you can check out my video on making 3D prints interactive, where I walk through how to approach these kinds of designs. That same process can also be applied to things like adding lights or magnets, and these small additions can instantly give a print more purpose and value. The main thing to keep in mind here is timing. So if you are using extra components like NFC chips, magnets, lights, make sure you order those as soon as possible so that they arrive in time. And once you have them though, they're actually very easy to design around and print. Now, if you are really pressed for time and just want to create something custom quickly, you can also check out MakerLab on MakerWorld. There are a ton of tools for things like ornaments, image to keychain tools, statues, and lithophanes. A lot of these tools are free to experiment with, and while some exports may require credits, it's a great option if you want something made by you without starting completely from scratch. Anyways, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully this video gave you some ideas for easy 3D printed gifts that you can make this holiday season. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks again. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and I'll see you all in the next video.